If the saying that leaders are born, not made, should hold sway, then High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onunkwo Onwamuchu is a born leader. No doubt, he is making waves even without any political office yet. Engineer John Bosco Onunkwo is a bona fide son of Umuchu in Agwatalukwu government area of Anambra State in southeast Nigeria. A grassroots politician and a staff in an oil company. A renowned philanthropist that has affected people positively in different spheres of human endeavor.
Aha, jama'an Nigeria. Ga wakar arewa wadda suka shirya wa High Chief Engineer John Bosco shugaban SSN na kasa ga baki daya. Ai saurare lafiya.
High Chief Engineer
Samaza su kokwanta uban mara uba shugaban SSN na kasa baki da kai tsohon sekere kowa yazo gare ka sai ya lafa haka yiwa da shi daga Allah ba ta mutane ba tabbas
in the quest to meet some of the challenges of the people John Bosco Onunkwo Foundation was made manifest. This foundation is focused on caring for humanity and to rekindle the potentials of Nigerian youths. This it aims to achieve through four different sectors of a foundation: education, empowerment and skill acquisition, health and community development services. In education, however, the foundation has a scholarship scheme which currently runs at all levels from primary schools to tertiary institutions annually.
I'm a beneficiary from John Bosco Foundation, Onunkwo Foundation. I'm a beneficiary for his deeds, for sponsoring my school fees. So I'm thanking God for everything, and I'm saying that God protect him. I'm appreciating everything he has done. I'm a student of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Awka.
Project Back to School is one of our annual school projects which started last year. It is a way of helping the parents to get their words back to school after the August-long summer holidays. The foundation provided over 1,000 school bags and writing materials for about 5,000 school children. Youth empowerment is the driving force of the foundation. It believes in investing in the youths. It holds an annual youth exhibition and skill acquisition program through which skills and hidden potentials are discovered and funded to start up.
The John Bosco Onunkwo Foundation has been a very wonderful, beautiful platform. It's been able to help a lot of young people, including myself. Like when I wanted to start up my studio, I talked to the founder, High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onunkwo, and I told him my plans of things I wanted to do. And he, through his foundation, he gave me funding for me to be able to start up my studio. So for me, the Bosco Onunkwo Foundation in Anambra State, across the Southeast and in Nigeria, has been one of the best philanthropic organizations I know. They've been helping young people to grow their business, helping young people to get out of tight spots. For me, the Bosco Onunkwo Foundation is just about everything beautiful. And I encourage him to keep doing what he's doing, and of course ask other people around him to too in line of what he's doing, because he's been exceptional for the young people.
Media skill acquisition, brother, because this is a time of this is a media era, social media, digital media. How can I get to equip my people? Many persons, because right now certificates are no longer enough. If you are not skilled, you'll be skimmed out. So what I did, I had the idea, what I called the reinvent yourself media training. Okay, what do I do? Of course, it's going to cost money, because I'm not just going to do it alone. I needed to bring my friends from all the other parts of the world. I needed to get my friend from BBC World. I needed to get my friends from other television, other digital media experts, editing expert and all whatnot. It would cost money. I don't even have a venue. I've never done an event in Anambra before. I was so just too worried. I had the idea. It was burning in me. I didn't know what to do. Somebody told me about the John Bosco Onunko Foundation. I don't know. He now gave me a number. I think that number was supposed to be number of the founder, High Chief John Bosco Onunko. And what I did, I placed a call. Unlike many big men, John Bosco picked my call just at the first rank, and I was almost scared, like, are you sure he's the one? No, it's a question. And what I did, I now spoke to him. I explained my dreams with him. I shared what I wanted to do. Being a man who is used to helping people, being a man who is used to equipping the youth, he understood me without much hassle. Then he would refer me to somebody. I think the person is a member of his foundation, or somebody maybe who works for his foundation or something. And the person also spoke with me, also got my brief and everything. Within a short time, I set my budget. They partnered with me. Not just funding it. John Bosco Onunko Foundation didn't just fund it. They partnered with me. In fact, all I did was just step into the venue of the event that day, because they got everything fixed. And I was just almost shocked. And the beautiful thing is that just very few months after, the feedback of that skill acquisition program has been pouring in, because it was a 5 days media training with feeding, free feeding, and every other perks associated with it. What we did, just few months down the line, the feedback had been awesome. And I'm eternally grateful for John Bosco Onunko Foundation for partnering with me, for sharing my dream, because all I had was just an idea and John Bosco Onunko gave it a meaning. I think the second edition of that event is coming pretty soon, this August. I can't wait to partner with John Bosco Onunko Foundation. Thank you, John Bosco Onunko Foundation. I am proud to associate with you. My name is Tabitha.
Last year, the foundation donated some bags to different individuals in Agwataloku garment area to help them start up their motorcycle transportation businesses.
Okay, I'm Michael and the John Bosco Onunko Foundation. I'm Michael and the new brand machine on January 1st. I'm Michael. Nice chineke. I go zibe. Ebo na naga. Uzo gana wada zibe wadere.
You're a man with a heart of gold. We need a leader like you in Nigeria. Men like you are hard to find. God bless ya, God bless ya. You brought smile on our faces. You are a father to us, a son. You are the hero of our time. God bless ya. You mean a lot to SSN. Thanks for the love you've shown to us. Niger is proud of you.
Thanks for the kindness, thanks for the support. 'Cause you have always been there.
The health project of a John Bosco Onunpo Foundation started at the inception of the foundation in 2016. It focuses mainly on the two major non-communicable diseases that poses a menace to the health of the populace, hypertension and diabetes. These gave birth to Agwata Free Medical Tour. The target is to visit the entire 14 communities in Agwata local government area, giving them free treatment, educating and sensitizing the populace on hypertension and diabetes, as well as other diseases like cancer, its symptoms and preventive measures, and donations of health kits for home check, free eye tests and reading glasses. The Agwata Free Medical Tour started on March 17, 2018, which involved a health walk of about 60 kilometers with the theme Agwata Walk for Health.
Service above service.
Wow.
So that's what we do. What we do is, it's written in the Bible, bring the help, the little you have, give out to the society. And when you give out to the society, other people will learn that it's always beneficial to serve the people. Thank you so much. These are what that we give to people after the exercise to make them happy. My good people, I thank you so much. This Agwata Free Medical Care. Today we are in Ibuku. We are going town by town in the entire Agwata local government. It's remaining three towns to complete Agwata local government. The idea is to bring healthcare down to the doorstep. The idea is to create awareness that people always have untimely deaths because of lack of exercise, because of lack of regular checking of your body. We want to tell the people that it's important to exercise your body, no matter the age. If you're very old, you can just walk around. If you're still in the middle class, once in a while, come out and exercise. Then, very important, make sure you check your BP, make sure you check your cholesterol, make sure you check every part of your body. So what we are doing to Ibuku people is to make sure that they have the free medical care. We check your cholesterol, we check your BP, we check your eye. Then if you are having some issues, we give you the medicine and also follow you up. Not just giving you up, follow you up and then make sure that you are okay. We also provide regular checks and also provide the kits that we will use to make sure that we do the BP. And we also make sure that we drop these kits and teach it to either your town union executives or your medical team in the town. Most towns that we discover that they have a health center, we donate these medical kits to the health center and teach them how to use it.
Nke mbụ godo Chineke were ndụ chọrọ nya mma. Chineke
ke wele ndo choro nyamo wele ke choro nyamo wele nwa akotiri akotiri choro nyamo ọpụpụ ya na mbata ya chineke ga na-ekpuri na-ekpere ya azụ chineke na-aga ọ na-eso chineke na-azụ ọ gaghị ebuchi ya ụzọ ọ ga-agbọgbu onwe ya n'ọsọ chie ga na-eburu ya ụzọ na-eso ya n'azụ ihe niile bụ ihe ọma ọ na-achọ na ndụ a dịka ntụrụ nata ikuku ngọzi ya ihe niile niile nke ihe ọma obu n'obi na ndụ ọ ga-enweta ya n'afọ Jizọs Kraịst
This is what someone can be doing for his people. The essence of if God bless you, the way of showing appreciation to God is this type of thing. Because if you see, there are a lot of deaths in our local government, in our communities. Those deaths, we would have prevented it if we're not careless about it. This issue of telling people the importance of checking their BP, all this present medicine that they take care of people is what people can do. I really appreciate the most commander for doing this type of thing for Agwata people and for Iboku precisely.
Hypertension and diabetes is a major cause of blindness in our society. Thus, we also bring the ophthalmologist to come along. And if you have any need for glasses, we also give free glasses. And finally, if you have any need for cataract surgeries, we are much interested in it. We do cataract surgeries for anybody.
Yeah, or with the first one.
We pick them out and take them. We take them to Guinness Eye Center at Onitsha and foot the bills of everything.
All the projects of the foundation in the past includes donation of food materials to the widows and the needy.
John Bosco, I mean, don't tell me when they are tell me when you under Najida is a kumuta ne musungi da din wannan taimako. Wato Allah saka da alheri kokarin ta. Shine ko wanda zan fara.
Bosco, Onowanko Foundation for providing this wheelchair for us. Thank you very much. May God bless you.
The John Bosco Onowanko Foundation has also donated a piano worth of 1.7 million naira to Bishop Valeria Okeke Music Academy. Archbishop Valeria Okeke is the Bishop of the Basilica of the Most Holy Trinity, Diocese of Onitsha. Still, for his self-love and altruistic heart, John Bosco Onowanko Foundation, under the sole sponsorship of a founder, High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onowanko, has gone ahead to erect a hospital structure in his hometown, Achala, Omuchu, in Agwata local government area. The hospital, which is at the plastering stage as at the time of filing this report, is a 14-room bed hospital structure with a theater, currently on the equipping stage now. To High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onowanko, this is wishing him more grease to his elbows as he keeps up the good work.